table for three.
Bateman, you look a little wild-eyed, rough day at the
Bryce,
office.
B-R-Y-C-E.
Hey, look, Bryce is back, and he's drinking mineral water. Yeah. He's a changed man, except he still can't get a reservation to save his life. Why don't you just try 150 Wooster?
I'm not going anywhere unless we have a reservation.
Le Cirque Flamingo East. Oyster bar. Come on, faggots, let's get a res.
Keep your shirt on. Maybe lose the suspenders.
Need a reservation for 8:30.
Excuse me, gentlemen. Right back.
10 Wood would not be any good.
No.
Just fucking call them. Give me the phone, I'll do it.
I'll call you back.
Face it, the Japanese will own most of this country by the end of the 90s.
Shut up, Carnes. They will not. So, Harold, did you get my message?
Jesus, yes, that was hilarious. That was you, wasn't it?
Yeah, naturally.
Bateman killing Allen and the escort girls. That's fabulous. That's rich.
What exactly do you mean?
The message you left. By the way, Davis, how's Cynthia? You're still seeing her, right?
Wait, Harold. What do you mean?
Oh, excuse me, nothing. It's good to see you. Is that Edward Towers?
Come on, wait.
Davis, I'm not one to badmouth anyone. Your joke was amusing. But come on, man. You had one fatal flaw. Bateman is such a dork. Such a boring, spineless lightweight. Now, if you said Bryce or McDermott, otherwise it was amusing. Now, if you'll excuse me, I really must be going.
Wait. Stop. I did it, Carnes. I killed him. I'm Patrick Bateman. The whole message I left on your machine was true.
Excuse me. I really must be going now.
No, listen. Don't you know who I am? I'm not Davis. I'm Patrick Bateman. We talk on the phone all the time. Don't you recognize me? You're my lawyer. Now, Carnes, listen. Listen very, very carefully. I killed Paul Allen. And I liked it. I can't make myself any clearer.
But that's simply not possible. And I don't find this funny anymore.
It never was supposed to be. Why isn't it possible?
It's just not.
Why not, you stupid bastard?
Because I had dinner with Paul Allen twice in London. Just 10 days ago.
No, you... didn't.
Now, if you'll excuse me.
We've seen the results of that mistrust in the form of lies, divisions, and mistakes. We need to find a way to cooperate while realizing foreign policy can't be run by committee. And I believe there's now the growing sense that we can accomplish more by cooperating. And in the end, this may be the eventual blessing in disguise to come out of the Iran-Contra mess.
How can he lie like
there
that?
There are now 17 months left in this administration.
How can he pull that shit?
What shit? Now, where do we have reservations at? I mean, I'm not really hungry, but I'd like to have reservations someplace.
How can you be so fucking, I don't know, cool about it?
Some guys are just born cool, I guess.
My hopes for this country are as fervent today as they were in Bateman. What are you so fucking zany about?
I'm just a happy camper. Rocking and a rolling.
Oh, brother, look. He presents himself as this harmless old codger, but inside.
But inside doesn't matter.
Inside, yes, inside. Believe it or not, Bryce, we're actually listening to you.
Come on, Bateman. What do you think?
Whatever.
This moronic idea was a door to dry beers. I need a scotch. Judge Robert Bork. When I named him to the U.S. Court of Appeals, the American Bar Association.
There are no more barriers to cross. All I have in common with the uncontrollable and the insane, the vicious and the evil, all the mayhem I have caused and my utter indifference toward it, I have now surpassed. My pain is constant and sharp, and I do not hope for a better world for anyone. In fact, I want my pain to be inflicted on others. I want no one to escape. But even after admitting this, there is no catharsis. My punishment continues to elude me, and I gain no deeper knowledge of myself. No new knowledge can be extracted from my telling. This confession has meant nothing.